So, for as badass as I think I am, or like to think I am, in the back of my mind, I am always fully aware of the fact that at any moment, I could be raped. And the fact that I'm totally paranoid doesn't detract from the fact that this is true. So, when someone picked up NYU student Emmett St. Guillen, sodomized her, raped her repeatedly, shoved a tube sock down her throat, cut off her long black hair, and put masking tape over her face, then sliced up her genital area before dumping her by the Belt Parkway. It didn't escape me for one second that that just as easily could have been me. To begin with, the bar she was last seen alive in is around the corner from my house. And that's just to begin with. For the first few days, I locked myself in my apartment. It actually got to the point where I was afraid to take a shower. And this isn't some boogeyman fantasy. I have read nearly every FBI criminal book and every Ann rule book ever printed. Ignorant people who love me tried to tell me I was overreacting. But it was useless. I know what the fuck I'm talking about. I said from the get-go, the person who did this to Emmett was a serial killer. And everyone was like, Perel, get a grip. So I did. I went to the John Vini gun shop, also conveniently located around the corner from my apartment, bought a mace and a screecher, which kind of looks like a baby fire extinguisher, but makes like this really loud noise. I bought a big ass hunting knife, which if need be, I could slice off someone's testicles. I tried to buy a stun gun, but the Chinese man behind the counter said, "Horis only." I mean, in addition to being able to totally immobilize someone, figured it'd make a pretty sexy accessory. I made do. For about 2 weeks, I walked around with my hands in my pockets, the screecher in one hand and the mace in the other. I was petrified. I was also ready to seriously fuck someone up. When I profiled the killer over dinner, I explained that someone who commits a crime like this has raped before, and it's clear because of the way it was done. Based on the fact that it was so violent, he'd likely been fantasizing about this for years. My friend looked at me and said, "Dead man." "Wow, P, you're really gonna crack this case wide open." I was like, "You can make fun of me if you want, but you'll see. And when they find this guy, he'll rape to kill before. If they don't catch him, he will definitely do it again. This guy gets off on this. Don't you get it? He likes this. It's a game to him. He enjoys the torture. And I'm not going down," I screamed as I exhibited my array of weaponry. My friend continued to look at me as though I had completely lost my mind. I continued. Emmett St. Guillen was a student of forensic psychology. If anyone knew these sociopaths, it was her. Two of her fingernails were ripped off. Do you know what that means? She fought like a fucking tiger. Don't you get that? It means if it could happen to her, it could happen to anyone. Oh wait, you're a guy. You have nothing to worry about. Serial killers almost never go after grown men. So there you fucking go, with your 6 feet of height and your dick between your legs. You got nothing to worry about. Except for me. You should be worried about me. You should be very worried about me. Because the reality is, literally at any moment, I could be raped. This is a fact lost on most men. Not because they don't love us, but more because they just don't understand what it feels like to walk down a dark alley at night and see a creepy man and literally be scared for your life. So for Emmett, a and all the other women who have met their fate in a way so hideous most of us can't even imagine. I'm thinking of you, and no, I am bathing again. I'm still carrying a knife in my back pocket.